Hello friends, so today I received an Oreo 8.1 update for my LG Q6. As you can see, that update is already in downloading state. So initially, as you can see, my phone is running Android 7.1.1 Nougat. Video, I am going to show you what's the difference in Android 7.7.1 and the Android 8.1 made for LG Q6. It was a mid-range device and it runs on Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 with 3GB of RAM, and the price was around 13,000. So this is a changelog of the update. As you can see, if you pause, you will be able to read. However, I am going to tell you in short, it had few of the optimizations in the performance. It had a complete new display overhaul, display user interface. It has a new comfort view, or what we call as night mode in many other displays. Also, it has a special 3D audio system, which is in par with most of the other LG G series and LG V series phones. Also, it has a new option so that we can use the LED flashlight or as a notification light. The only biggest downside of this phone was the absence of notification light, but this update is made to get that absence rectified. So it took me around 20 minutes for the update to be done, and in the process the phone became hot and it was so slow. In fact, if you keep on watching the video, you will be able to see that my phone had stopped turning the screen on. So, LG Q6 offers a full view display, 18:9 aspect ratio. This was quite new in the beginning of 2016 and at the price range of around 13,000. This phone is a decent performance, but the price should be a bit more less. Nonetheless, the phone is durable. However, the aluminum frame has started receiving some scratches, and they call it a military standard phone. I don't think so. According to my opinion, it's not. As you can see, the phone has freezed. It is not responding to the power button, neither the screen is turning on. Only if you see on the top of the front camera, the IR sensor is blinking, that is the phone is turned on. However, the screen wasn't turning on for a few minutes. Later on, it did turn on right now. As you can see, finishing Android update, it's showing on the screen. I will quickly unlock my phone and let's check if there is some new design or new user interface. As you can see, there is a considerable amount of lag. Let's go to the quick settings. I will adjust my lights. Yeah. This is the app drawer. It's completely the same. There is no such differences in the previous and new version. The notification drawer seems to be exactly the same. Let's go to settings. Here is a thing which has a complete revamped design, and that's with the setting option. As you can see, there is very minimal amount of options available. And if I go to the about section, you will be able to see that the phone is currently running on the Android 8.1.0 Oreo and not the default 8.0 Oreo. The security patch is of the September month. Let's see some other features. I will set this as default for now, home and app drawer, because I am comfortable with the app drawer. Many of you might think other option is better, but for me app drawer is much more comfortable. Keeping it aside, let's go to the settings again to check some more changes in the display or the sound. So let's go. First option I chose was the suggestion tab. It is new in the Android 8.1 and it works seemingly well with the LG Q6 as well. Let's go to the display option. Home screen is nonetheless same. However, also the home screen button is the same. But there is one feature which has been added of called as hide home touch button. This is very useful if you are playing games or watching YouTube videos in other devices, for instance OnePlus devices. It's called as gaming mode. It basically hides the navigation keys on a tap of a button. I found it very useful in my future experiences and I love this feature. Number 2 was the comfort view option. As you can see, there are more options in comfort view. I can schedule the comfort view. I can increase the saturation level. And let's go to sound. As you can see in sound, there is an option for sound quality and effects, DTS 3D surround sound. So this works only when I plug in the earphones. However, this wasn't present in the last version.